Welcome to the session, dear students. So in my last class I taught you circles and two basic equations you have learnt, that is equation of circle with center origin, that is x square plus y square equal to r square. Then you also learnt equation of circle with center h comma k, x minus h the whole square plus y minus k the whole square equal to r square. Then I also taught you standard equation in my next session, that is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. And we have also discussed problems based on that. In today's session, we will go ahead with problems of equations of circle, and also we will learn circle when diameter ends are given. So now, equation of circle when diameter ends are given. All of you know what is diameter. For a given circle, diameter is the longest chord. So if I draw a circle, you can draw many chords. Chord means what? Any line joining. So, line joining any two points, suppose PQ, line joining two points on the circle is a chord. The longest chord which passes through center, this is what? Diameter. So, when they give diameter ends, when they give this A value and B value, you can still find the equation of circle. So, I taught you equation of circle when centers are given. Now, they will give ends of diameter. You can see, I have drawn a circle here. And what is one end? X1, Y1. What is other end? X2, Y2. This is the circle and AB is the diameter. In this diagram, AB is the diameter. It is passing through center. So, diameter is passing through what? Center. C is the center. Now, I will discuss derivation of equation of circle. We will derive equation of circle when ends of diameter are given. When ends of what are given? Diameter. So, you can see I have drawn a circle. A x1 y1, b x2 y2 are the ends of diameter, and p x y b any point on the circle. You can choose this point anywhere on the circle. I have chosen here. So now to derive, first you should write the considerations. So now I will write the considerations. I am considering a circle. Consider a circle with diameter ends, one end is A x1 y1 and B x2 y2. So, you can see in the diagram I have taken a circle and one end is x1 y1, the other end is x2 y2. Let P is equal to xy. P xy be a point on the circle. These are the considerations. So, now if I join AP and BP, and you can see in the diagram, AP is exactly perpendicular to what? BP. AP is perpendicular to what? BP. So, first to derive, you should write the considerations. Consider a circle with diameter ends A x1 y1, B x2 y2, P be any point on the circle, and if you join AP and BP, you know angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees, so this is exactly 90 degrees, means AP and BP are perpendicular. In first P, you see straight lines, you studied, if two lines are perpendicular, then product of their slopes is minus 1. If two lines are perpendicular, then the product of slopes is minus 1. To derive this, you should know two concepts. One concept, if two lines are perpendicular, then the product of their slopes is minus 1. So, here from the figure, now let us derive. From the figure, can I say AP is exactly perpendicular to BP? And if two lines are perpendicular, what is the condition? If two lines are perpendicular, then the product of their slopes is minus 1. So, because they are perpendicular, so I can write slope of AP, product means what? Multiplication. Slope of AP into slope of BP is minus 1. You studied in your first PUC. Coordinate geometry, straight lines chapter you studied. So, in straight lines you learned that slope of, if two lines are perpendicular, so in product of slopes is minus 1. Here AP and BP are perpendicular, therefore slope of AP into slope of BP is minus 1. Now, how to find slope of line joining points? All of you know, slope of line joining points is difference of y coordinate by difference of x coordinate. How to find slope of line joining points? Difference of y coordinate divided by difference of x coordinate. Now, I will find slope of AP. So, slope of AP means difference of y coordinate. What is y here? Y value is y. What is y here? Y1. So, subtract y values. Y minus y1 divided by some difference of x coordinate. What is the x coordinate? X and x1, x minus x1. So you know how to find slope of line joining points because you studied this slope of line joining points in first PUC. So if I give any line segment, suppose this is a line segment BPQ and it is having 2, 3, 1, 2, suppose. Then how to find slope? Slope is what? Slope of line joining points is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Difference of y, y here is 2, 3. So 2 minus 3 divided by y x 1 minus 2. If you subtract this, you will get a number. That is slope. How to find slope? Y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Here y2 means y, y1 means y1, y minus y1 by x minus x1. This is slope of AP. This is slope of AP into slope of BP. Now I need to find slope of BP. Can you see the diagram? Slope of BP. How to find slope of BP? Difference of y coordinate. What is difference of y coordinate? Y minus y2 divided by difference of x coordinate. What is difference of x coordinate? X minus x2. X minus x2. So now y minus y2 divided by x minus x2. This is slope of line BP is equal to what? Minus 1. Logic is simple. All of you learnt in first year PUC. If two lines are perpendicular, then product of the slopes is minus 1. Here AP and BP are perpendicular. Therefore, slope of AP into slope of BP is what? Minus 1. And how to find slope of line joining points? How to find slope of line joining point? Difference of y by difference of x. So y value is y, y value is y1, y minus y1 by x minus x1. And here y minus y2 by x minus x2. We have done it. Now transfer the denominator. Whole denominator goes this side, it will become into. So numerator, that implies y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to, transfer this to this side, it will become minus x1 into x minus x2. Now bring this negative term. If you bring this whole negative term to this side, it will become positive. That implies x minus x1 into x minus x2. This is already positive, plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to 0. This is the equation of circle when ends of diameter are given. What is the equation of circle when ends of diameter are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. This is the equation of circle when ends of diameter is given. This is the equation of circle when ends of diameters are given. What is the equation of circle when diameter ends are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. How to derive? Simple. Consider a circle. A and B are the ends of diameter. A is x1, y1. B is x2, y2. Choose any point P on the circle, x, y. And then join AP and BP. If you see, angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees. So, AP and BP are perpendicular. If two lines are perpendicular, all of you know, product of slopes is minus 1. So, slope of AP into slope of BP is minus 1. How to find slope of AP? Difference of y coordinate by difference of x coordinate. And for BP also, difference of y by difference of x. Denominator will transfer, it will become into, bring this term to LHS, it will become plus. Then finally, you will get the answer, x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to what? 0. So, now we got the answer, that is equation of circle when diameter ends are given. Now we will do problems based on this. So first you should know what is the equation of circle when ends of diameters are given. I told you in any other chapter you should know definition and formula, but in this chapter you should know equation. Nodi bere chapter galalli neevu definition nu formula kalthibeku, adu ee chapter alli equations. First we learnt equation of circle with center origin. What is the equation of circle with center origin? X square plus y square equal to r square. Then we learnt equation of circle with center hk. What is the equation? X minus h the whole square plus y minus k the whole square equal to r square. Then I taught you standard equation. What is standard equation of circle? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Today we are learning fourth equation, that is equation of circle when ends of diameter are given. When what are given? When ends of diameter are given. So first you should know this. What is equation of circle with diameter ends? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. This is the equation of circle. What is the equation of circle when diameter ends are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. They will not give the equation. So now you should memorize the equation. You should remember the equation to solve the problems. First one, we derived it. Always you can't sit and derive. So these are all two markers. Or sometimes it'll ask for 1 mark also. So just you should know equation. What is the equation of circle when diameter ends are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Now ends of diameters are given. So first question, they have given diameter ends, they named it as A and B. So A is one of the end of diameter, that is 2 comma minus 1, call it as x1 y1, and they gave B. What is B? Second end of the diameter, that is minus 2 comma 1, call it as x2 y2. So all of you know, when they give circle and one end is A, the other end is B, and we say A as x1 y1, B as x2 y2, they gave that. So now required equation, what is required equation? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 is what? 0. Now substitute. So x minus, what is x1? 2. Into x minus x2, what is x2? Minus 1. Plus y minus y1, what is y1? Minus 1. What is y into y minus y2, what is y2? 2. Equal to 0. While substituting, don't do silly mistake. X1, Y1 is in first pair, X2, Y2 is in second pair. So, while substituting, do it carefully and don't do mistakes. Now, that implies X minus 2 into X plus 1 plus Y plus 1 into Y minus 2. Simplify this further. So, multiply this X into X, X square plus X minus 2X minus 2 plus Y into Y, Y square minus 2Y plus Y minus 2 equal to 0. Simplify. Can I write x square plus y square? X minus 2x is minus x. Minus 2y minus y is minus y. And minus 2 minus 2 becomes minus 4 equal to 0. X square plus y square minus x minus y minus 4 equal to 0. This is a final answer. Any doubts? I hope all of you understood. Similarly, they will ask you to find the equation of circle passing with ends of diameter. So, we call this as what? X1, Y1. We call this as what? X2, Y2. What is the equation? X minus X1, X minus minus 2 into X minus X2. What is X2? X minus 3 plus Y minus Y1, Y minus of minus 1 into Y minus Y2. What is Y2? Minus 1 is equal to what? 0. Simplify this. X plus 2 into x minus 3 plus y plus 1 into y plus 1 equal to 0. Multiply this, so it will become x square minus 3x plus 2x minus 6. Again, this is a plus b into a plus b is a plus b the whole square. Can I use y plus 1 the whole square? So it will become y square plus 1 plus 2y, or term wise you multiply, you will get the same. So x square plus y square minus x plus 2y minus 5 equal to 0. So, when ends of diameter is given, just memorize this equation and solve the problems. I hope all of you understood. What is the equation of circle when ends of diameter are given? X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Next, in today's class, we will also discuss some of the interesting concepts, that is, find the equation of circle passing through 2, 3 and having its center on x axis and radius 5. These are all the standard 5 markers. So, or sometimes your questions will be for 6 marks. So, circles questions, they've asked for 6 marks. One marker, one 6 marker, or one 5 marker, one marker they've asked. So, now these are all the questions, 5 or 6 marks. Find the equation of circle. They want you to find the equation of circle. And they told it is passing through 2, 3. They gave a hint it is passing through 2, 3. And they told center on x-axis. Center is on x-axis. See, we can solve by two methods, taking center as hk and radius as 5. So, here they told it is passing through 2, 3. They have not given center. If you want to write equation of circle, you should know center and radius or standard equation. Whenever they ask you to find the equation of circle, let us start the solution with let x square plus y square plus, what is the standard equation of circle? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So, let x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 be the required circle. This is the circle. Be the required circle. I got the circle equation, but what are the unknowns? G, F, C. But they gave center lies on x-axis. What is the hint given? Center lies on x-axis. Can I say center? What is center? Minus G minus F. This is on what axis? X-axis. All of you know, if any point is on x-axis, its y value is 0. You studied in first PUC point plotting techniques. So, if any point is on x-axis, its y coordinate is 0. We call this as x-coordinate, we call this as y-coordinate. Center is on what axis? X-axis. Therefore, its y value is 0. Therefore, minus f is 0. R that implies f you got. What is f you got? Minus f is 0, f is also 0. Why f is 0? Because it is y coordinate. Why y coordinate becomes 0? Because it is on x axis. If any point lies on x axis, its y value is 0. So now your center is lying on x axis. So what is the y coordinate of center? Minus f is 0. If minus f is 0, f is also 0. All of you know center for standard equation. So what is standard equation? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus equals 0. In that you got this. And now I will substitute this. Now further they told circle passes through a point. What is the point? 2, 3. If any circle passes through any point, you can put the point in the circle equation. I can put the point in circle equation. In the place of x and y, I can substitute. In the place of x, put 2, and in the place of y, put 3. So then it will come 2 square plus 3 square plus 2g into 2 plus 2f into 3 plus c equal to 0. Simplify, 2 square is 4. I am repeating, if circle passes through any point, if any point is on the circle, you put the point in circle. Substituting the point in circle means in the x coordinate place you put the x value, in the y coordinate place put the y value. Now 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, and 4g plus 6f plus c equal to 0. And you know already f value. What is f value? 0. You substitute f also. So 9 plus 4, 13 plus 4g plus 6 into f, you know 0 plus c. So directly you get an equation 4g plus c 13. You transfer 13 to that side. Can I say minus 13? Now we got equation 2. Now we got 4g plus c is minus 13. F value got. Now gc. And they gave radius. What is the radius? 5 units. What is radius given? 5 units. My question to you. What is the radius of standard circle? Radius of standard circle is root of g square plus f square minus c is 5. This is radius. Radius given is 5. R is 5. So, but you know the formula for radius. What is the formula for radius? Root of g square plus f square minus c. That is. And you know f value. So, g square plus f is 0 square minus c is equal to 5. I am squaring on both sides. Whole square. So, when you square root cancels, I am left out with g square minus c is equal to 25. Here I have 4g plus c equal to minus 13. From this, you can get c value. And substitute c here, you will get two values for g. 4g plus c is minus 13. Can't you get g from this? That implies, see, from this you can get c. What is c? G square minus 25. So in the place of c you can put g, or from here you can get c and substitute anything, fine. So better I will get from this only. C akadakal, see, c g square minus 25. Now you got c value. What is c value? G square minus 25. So call this as equation 2. Already 2 is there. So call it as equation 3. Now substitute 2 in 3. So now we need to solve simultaneous equations carefully. Substitute equation 3 into. So that is 4g plus c. Instead of c, what is c value? C is g square minus 25. 4g plus g square minus 25 is equal to minus 13. Here we have minus 13. Rearrange this. First I will write g square. Bring this plus 4g minus 25 plus 13 is equal to 0. That is g square plus 4g minus 25 plus 13. Simplify this. Minus 25, that is
is equal to 0.
Now we got a quadratic equation. I need to solve this. What is the quadratic equation? G square plus 4g minus 12. I hope all of you understood till this part. First we got f0, then we got c g square minus 25. Then I substituted in this, I got a quadratic equation. Now I need to solve that. Now our task is to solve that. We'll solve it. Now you got f and you got a quadratic equation g. Solve the quadratic equation. That is g square plus 4g minus 12. What are the factors for minus 12? That will give you plus 4. So you can take 6 2s are 12. I will take 6 into minus 2. Do middle term factorization. G square plus 6g minus 2g minus 12 is equal to 0. Take g common, minus 2 common. All of you know middle term factorization. So, I am doing middle term factorization. I will get g values, two different g values. So, g value 1 is minus 6, the other g value is 2. So, you can put this two g values separately and you will get two different set of circles. So, now at g is equal to 2, what is c? What is c you got? G square minus 25. C is g square minus 25. That is 2 square minus 25. 4 minus 25 minus 21. One value of c is minus 21. So you got one set. So and at g is equal to minus 6. At g is equal to minus 6. Now put g here. G value minus 6 in this equation 3. In equation 3 you will get c. What is c? G square minus 6 square. Here minus 25 minus 6 the whole square is 36. 36 minus 25, that is 11. Now you got c value. So at this g, so now you got two sets. So we'll write one set and we'll write one equation. Always f is 0, and when g is 2, c is minus 21, and when g is minus 6, c is 11. So we got two equations. They want you to find the equation of what? Circle. Now we can write the equation of circle. To write the equation of circle, first you should get g of c. So I told you circle and x-axis means f is 0. Then passes through any point means put the point. After you put the point, you will get an equation. Radius 5 means root of g square plus f square minus c is 5. You will get another equation. Solve the simultaneous equations. When you solve the simultaneous equations, you will get g f and c. After you get g f and c, we will write the equation. Okay, now you got g of c, one set I will take. One set f 0 and g value 2 and corresponding c value minus 21 and circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c. Equation 1, that is circle. So I am putting in this e equation only, substitute g of c. So f is 0. So this 0 into anything 0. So x square plus y square plus 2 into g. What is g? 2 into g into x plus 2 into f. F is what? 0. Y minus 21 equal to 0. Simplifying this, you will get one circle. That is x square plus y square plus 4x. But 2 zeros are 0. Leave it. Minus 21 equal to 0. This is one of the circle equation. The wanted circle, we got circle. Any doubts? Now I need to write other circle. I will take this pair. That is when g is minus 6, f is 11. So what is the required equation? X square plus y square plus 2gx. What is the g value? Minus 6. And f is always 0. 20y minus plus c. What is c? 11 equal to 0. Simplify this. We will get x square plus y square minus 12x plus 11 equal to 0. This is the second circle. So we got two circles. Now this is one circle equation. This is other circle equation. They wanted to find equation of circle. We got equations of circle because we got two values of g corresponding two values of c. So two different circle equations we wrote. What is the standard equation of circle? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. If circle passes through any point, in this problem circle was passing through 2, 3. In the circle equation, in the place of x and y, put 2 and 3. And they told radius is 5. So equate this to radius formula, root of g square plus f square minus c. So when you equate this, you will get this. And center lies on what axis? X axis. Center is lying on x axis means f is 0. This is the hints. So they will give hints, create equations, solve simultaneous equation and get the equation of circle. I hope all of you understood this. So like this, different cases they'll give, you need to solve. Now next question, find the equation of circle passing through origin. It is passing through origin and another point 1 1 center on x axis. Interesting, simple. See, first always start, let x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is the circle. This is the circle, B the circle. This is your answer. This is your answer, but we need gf and c. If circle passes through origin, in the place of x and y put 0, 0. This is 0, this is 0. 0 into anything 0. So you will get c 0. So circle means 1 passes through 0, 0. Passes through 0, 0. If any circle passes through 0, 0, not center is origin. It is, see, now this is a circle, it is passing through origin. So if it passes through origin, if I put 0 square plus 0 square plus, in the place of x and y, put 0, 0. 2g into 0 plus 2f into 0 plus c is equal to 0. So everything becomes 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0, c. So you will get c value 0. Directly, no need to do these steps. Just to make you understand, I told you in last problem, if a circle passes through any point, put the point in circle. Circle enadru point mulka pass adre, a point na circle equation will aki. Now circle is passing through 0, 0. In the place of x and y, put 0, 0, you will get c 0. Or this is a time waste and blunder. Don't waste your time. So directly you can say, circle passes through what? Origin. Through 0, 0. 0, 0 means what? Origin, all of you know. Therefore, if any circle passes through origin, c value is 0. What is circle equation? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals 0. In that, c is directly 0 because it is passing through origin. Students, now onwards, if they give circle passes through origin, put c value 0. Then, circle passes through 1 comma 1 and also center means what? Minus g minus f lie on x axis. This is lying on x axis. I told you in my last problem also, if center lies on x axis, its y coordinate is 0. Therefore minus f is 0 or f is 0. So you got f directly, you got c directly. Now I'll use this hint, that is passing through what? This. I told you, when you start the problem, what is the first step? Let x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 be the circle. This is the circle. This is your answer. In this answer, you got c. C is how much? 0. In this answer, you got f. F is also 0. You need to find g. So now I'll tell 1. 1 means what? Equation 1 means circle. 1 passes through what? 1 passes through, what is given? 1 is passing through 1, 1. So now in circle equation, in the place of x and y, put 1, 1. So if you put that, I'll get 1 square plus 2g into 1. I'm putting 1, 1 in this equation. Plus 2f into 1 plus c equal to 0. And what is 1 square? 1. 1 square is 1. 2g into 1 is 2g. Plus 2, already you know f. What is f? 0. Substitute it. 2 into 0 into 1. Plus c also you know 0. From this directly you will get g. It's easier than last problem. 1 plus 1, 2. 2g. This is 0. Is equal to 0. So 2g is equal to what? Minus 2. Rearrange. Plus 2 goes. That's it. From minus 2. You got 2g. What is 2g? Minus 2. What is g? Into 2. Transfer this side will come by 2. 2, 2 cancels. What is g you got? Minus 1. So now you have g with you, f with you and c with you. G is minus 1. C is 0. And also you have f value. F is 0. So what is the required circle? You put g f c in equation 1. Therefore, circle is x square plus y square plus 2g. What is g value? Minus 1 into x plus 2f. What is f value? 0 into y plus c value. 0 is equal to 0. Simplify this. Final answer, x square plus y square minus 2x
is equal to 0. This is the circle equation.
So today I have done 2 5 mark problems. They want you to find circle equation. First step is what? Let x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, standard equation. This is the answer. If it passes through origin, c becomes 0. If center is on x axis, f becomes 0. Then to find g, put the point, you will get g. After you get gfc, substitute gfc values in the first equation, you will get the answer. So now I have done 5 markers, sample 5 markers. In my next class, we will continue with this. But before I start the session, I expect you people to become thorough with all the types of equations. So circle, all the equations should be thorough. Basically standard equation. What is standard equation? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Three unknowns, gfc. If you know gfc, you can write the equation. So we will continue with this 5 markers. I am expecting you people to become thorough with the equations. And today whatever I have done, the problems, same problems, you take a pen and paper and practice the same problems. I don't want any new problems. Once you are thorough with the 2 problems what I have done today, then other problems becomes easier. So in my next session, I will be continuing with 5 markers. Thanks for attending the session. Thank you.